Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and you probably know that what this video is going to be all about, and let's just assume you don't know anything about it. So without any further ado, let's get started.
The charger is a component that is provided as a standard when purchasing a smartphone. It is included with this by default because the battery can be used to continue using the smartphone. However, a market analyst...
Ming-Chi Guo
noted that Apple might ship next iPhone without a charger and wired earbuds in the box, which would be the first for the company. According to
Ming-Chi Guo,
Apple wants to keep the iPhone 12's price close to the iPhone 11, and ditching these accessories will help offset the cost of new 5G networking components. There is no word yet whether a lightning cable will be included. Although it isn't confirmed yet, I'd hate to see Apple going down this road. As 9to5 Max
Benjamin Mayo
noted that those accessories will set you back by about $63, or close to a tenth of the cost of $699 64GB iPhone 11. Apple could justify this in many different ways, but it doesn't seem to be consumer friendly. Sure, you might not explicitly need a new charger if you already own some other Apple product, but you might have a slow old one with frayed cables. It's also certain what sort of charger will be available when iPhone 12 comes out. The word on the street is Apple is working on 20-watt USB Type-C adapter to replace its existing 18-watt and 5-watt chargers. And that's the one you'll be able to buy separately. It all just seems a bit cumbersome when you don't have to do this with any other manufacturer's product. Apple is reportedly trying to shave cost by reducing the size of the packaging, which will reduce the shipping cost. The bulkiest item in the iPhone's package, besides the device itself, is 18-watt power adapter, is already said to have noted that Apple's decision to ditch accessories have something to do with helping the environment. I wonder if that will make some difference, particularly when people start buying accessories sold, packed, and shipped separately. This ties in well with the idea that most smartphone users out there already owns a slew of accessories that will fit in iPhone 12, including charger and headphones. Apple could help cut waste by producing fewer charging bricks and earbuds. According to UNU, in 2014, the amount of electronic waste on international level reached 41.8 million tons, and in 2018, it reached 50 million. Of this 50 million tons of electrical and electronic equipment waste, only 6.5 tons were collected, treated, and recycled, and the rest ended up in household rubbish mixed with organic leftovers and plastics. In a research noted provided to MacRumors analyst Jeff Pew, forecasted that iPhone 12 pricing will start at $749 for a new 5.4-inch model, an increase of $50 over the base model iPhone 11 for $699. Jeff said the price is primarily attributed to the addition of 5G and the OLED display of all iPhone 12 models, where the iPhone 11's display was LCD. Due to 5G, Jeff believes that the price increase will be accepted by the customer and will not affect demand. But the move would generate controversy nonetheless if the earpods and the wall charger are removed from the box as rumored. Extrapolating on Jeff's prediction, the 6.1-inch iPhone 12 would like to start at $799 or $849. So, customers who want to stick to the same display size as iPhone 11 could be facing a larger $100 to $150 price increase. It's unclear if a price increase would extend to the Pro and Pro Max models, which currently starting at $999 and $1099 respectively. So the main question arises is that by removing the wall charger and the earphones, is Apple actually preparing us for the next generation iPhones, which won't work without any traditional chargers or headphones? Moving on to next big news, Apple's biggest rival is following its lead in not including the power adapter with its upcoming phones. Samsung will no longer give customers a complimentary charger brick when they buy a new phone beginning next year. The world's biggest smartphone maker is making a switch because many customers have power adapters adapters already, and the change will help the company reducing the cost, according to the report. The news came just days after the Japan's Nikkei's Asian Review confirmed that the Apple is not including a charger or earbuds in the box with the false batch of iPhones. Chargers are not expensive components such as semiconductors and displays. However, as the smartphone market is saturated, it is interpreted that the manufacturers have reduced the cost to secure profitability and thus have to put the charger in the target. It is not final when and when Samsung Electronics will exclude the charger, but it is noteworthy how consumer will respond to this move. In recent years, when 5G and foldable functions are grafted to smartphones and the prices is rising, the perception that is very expensive is likely. Also, if the other rewards or benefits are not given instead of including the charger, it may lead to consumer complaint and may act a factor that hinders smartphone purchase. It is expected that Samsung Electronics policy will also affect related industries. Samsung Electronics is world's largest manufacturer with around 400 million smartphones annually. If Samsung Electronics reduce the purchase of chargers, it will inevitably have adverse effect on the companies that supplied them. Charger companies need to find a new source of purchase or jump into the direct market to consumer. Excluding chargers, Samsung Electronics as well as the global smartphone industry is a hot topic. Another big reason for ditching the charger could be that they might be preparing us for the future, a future with no strings attached, a wireless world. So what are your views on this? Let me know in the comment section below. And that will be all for this video. I'll see you in the next one.